Helping us with our discussion is sports writer Josh Planos. He writes for publications like the Washington Post and the New York Times. Josh now joins us live via Skype from Omaha, Nebraska. Good evening, Josh, and welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me, Paolo. We got some great basketball on tab.
Yeah, so let's take a look first at what happened between Milwaukee and Boston. Giannis taking control, carrying Milwaukee past Boston to force a game seven. Is this a feat you feel is something he can replicate once again to carry them past Boston in game seven?
I mean, I think it'll be difficult for no other reason than, you know, he's clearly working on a team that's already at a disadvantage coaching-wise. My roommate told me that Joe Prunty, Milwaukee's coach, looked like a calculus coach, just kind of, you know, wandered onto the court during a game instead of a basketball coach. And you're kind of seeing that a little bit tactically. You know, Brad Stevens is just kind of on another planet. You know, I don't think any other team would be in a series like this having lost two of its three best players. You know, they're without Kyrie, they're without Gordon Hayward, and yet they still seem like the team to beat. Of course, they're the higher seed, but, you know, for Giannis, this is really a great opportunity. I thought in game six, he really demonstrated that, you know, like how far he's come. If you're going to dominate the fourth quarter, I think he had, you know, more than 13 points. That was mighty impressive in my book, and I'm sure he wants to, you know, put a cherry on top of what has been a sensational Sunday of a season. And for them to advance, they're certainly going to need it. I would say at least 30 points out of him.
You know, it's no secret that the Bucks have the edge talent-wise, but how far can Brad Stevens take the Celtics in a Game 7 situation with, you know, a team that's not necessarily loaded with star talent?
Well, we know they're going to be incredible out of timeouts. He always draws up incredible plays. He gets everybody involved, which I think is something that, you know, not a lot of coaches do. They usually kind of reside on their, you know, their all-stars, their bona fide talents, and yet he seems to, you know, he'll draw up a play for Morris. He'll draw up a play for Terry Rozier. Terry Rozier's been, you know, super clutch this postseason. I think, you know, it's really going to come down to coaching, and I would assume that Brad Stevens is going to get it done because, you know, many sports writers have already enshrined him as one of the best coaches of the league, if not the best coach this season, and he's certainly putting it on display over the last few months.
Well, apart from that series, the next few games coming up, crackers of series, all of them at 3-2 right now. You have Toronto and Washington at 3-2, Toronto leading. Cleveland and the Pacers, Cleveland leading that 3-2. And Utah and OKC, Utah leading that one 3-2. Now, amongst these three series, which ones do you think will end in the next game or will extend to a Game 7 as well?
I think Utah and Cleveland just get the job done tonight. I really think that Quinn Snyder, I know I just talked about Brad Stevens being, you know, one of the best coaches of the year, but I don't know anybody who could have done a better job coaching this Utah team than Quinn Snyder. This team is remarkable, and I'm sure a lot of that has to do with Donovan Mitchell, but even more of it has to do with Snyder and the position that he's putting his team in. Defensively, they're just kind of imposing their will on OKC, so I'd expect them to get the job done here tonight. And then Cleveland, you know, you don't tempt the king, and that's all Lance Stevenson seems to do, and nobody seems to get, you know, LeBron ready for a series quite like Lance. So I think LeBron's, you know, pretty fired up and ready to end this thing tonight. So I would expect those two to wrap up. And, you know, Toronto, we just never know what we're going to get with them in the postseason. They seem to always, you know, find a hitch. You know, either Kyle Lowry can't shoot or, you know, mentally they kind of collapse in the fourth quarter. So I would expect Washington to, you know, push this to a seventh game, and you know, that's good for me. I'm trying to watch as much basketball as I can, so the longer these series go, the better for me.
Well, absolutely. Well, you mentioned a while ago about the OKC and the Jazz series that you feel that the Jazz will just out-execute OKC. But looking at how they collapsed in their last game against a beast that is Russell Westbrook, how confident are you that they can bounce back from such a terrible loss?
No, that's true. That really is tough to rebound from. But every game is a new opportunity, and I'm sure that's what Quinn Snyder's preaching to put those kind of, you know, ghosts of the last game out of their heads. You know, clear your head and get ready to finish this. Because I really think Joe Ingles has been remarkable. Donovan Mitchell, clearly. Gobert has been phenomenal. But the X factor to me is Derek Favors. This team is 3-0 when he goes for 10 or more points in the postseason. 0-2 when he doesn't. And he should really just kind of take, you know, Carmelo Anthony to the low block and get this thing done. So I'd expect Derek Favors to lead this team to a win, and I'd expect them to come out you know, clear-eyed and ready to compete.
And the only series that you think will extend the Raptors and the Wizards, the balance right now is a bit strange. Even though the Raptors are leading, it doesn't feel like they own the series yet. I agree with you there. But let's say it does extend to a seventh game. Who do you feel has the edge if it gets to that point?
I think Toronto, for no other reason than how cohesive they seem. I can't tell you how many times I've watched Washington play this year and seen them, you know, feud on the sideline. And I know that every great team has had some tension, whether it be in the locker room or out on the court throughout the season. But it genuinely feels like Washington's players don't like each other. Like, you know, Marcin Gortat is constantly throwing slights at John Wall and Bradley Beal. And I would expect that to really kind of take a toll when, you know, you're in crunch time. And Toronto's been the better team all season. So I'm going to side with them if we're talking about a do or die game. I think DeRozan's been a phenomenal leader, has shaped his game in a new way. Dwayne Casey's been a terrific coach this season. So I'd expect Toronto to get the job done if it goes to a seventh game.
Well, we'll keep your predictions in mind, Josh. Once again, thank you very much for joining us all the way here to the Philippines. Thank you very much for making time for us.
Thanks, Paolo.